Hello, this is a demonstration of how to build 3D electromagnetic models for AC coupling capacitor mounting structures, or DC decoupling capacitor, they often called. In the previous demo, I showed how to basically approach the problem first with optimization of the cross section for the part that for the mounting section and approximate analysis. And I use 3 button to 60 mil wide section between 50 ohm microstrip lines. So now let construct more accurate model for the IC coupling capacitor section, something like was done in this application node 2804. To do this, I create a new project, project 2. Nothing in there. Copy paste materials, copy paste stack up, and it'll extend stack up with one layer above for the capacitor part. Add layer above. Select it as a signal layer, cup, thickness 2 mil, filled with air. Okay, so now I create 3DML circuit in project 2, which should be a cup 1. Finish, and right here I have editor. In the editor, I need to create parts for the capacitor. First, I can create model for capacitor itself, which is going to be a short circuit in plate, which is with size along X 40 mil and along Y 20 mil, 0402 capacitor. Bottom part, and I hit escape to keep it like this. So next I'll put pads in here where the capacitor is mounted. I use again build rectangle in a layer signal 1. Pads will be size 20 by 20. I enter directly this 20 by 20, easy, and place it right here. Zimmer snaps everything to the grid. Grid truncation here is 1 mil. Can be redefined to have better accuracy. And now I use Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V, and simply highlight it here on the tree and move it. This is the second part. Well, one good thing to do is to combine all those models into one structure, cap one for instance, to be able to further move it around as a whole thing. So I put everything in there and check quit from editing mode with E and use D to see 3D structure. Now I can initialize it to basically extend a little bit. Now I need transmission line 8.25 mil on this end, on this end. So again, I switch to editing mode, go to T lines here, add T line. First T line is going to be along X axis. You can see X here. Geometry will be edited in the editor. Create input at the start side. Start at the beginning, one strip. This is going to be where the strip ends in the layer. Signal 1 width 825. In the previous demo, it shows that this is about 50 ohm port to the wall finish. And I hit escape everywhere here because of the position of the transmission line is exactly at zero coordinate along along y-axis. Again, for the excitation plane or reference plane here, I use escape to keep it at this location. So we've got one I/O here, transmission line embedded up to this location. Next, we repeat this operation, highlight T line, and go through the whole process again, only now create input at the end side over there. Again, right here, they're gonna be beginning in this case of the transmission line. It should be in layer signal 1, 825, and you can see it's 50 ohm. Simply evaluates it like this. Again, we don't move it right here, hit escape, and IO2. When you don't need to edit it, again I hit escape. The editor may be not even used, so you can simply edit on the tree view. To make model even more accurate, well, I'll need to increase the number of cells per bit to 8, similar to what used in transmission line analysis. Add the new simulation. 3DML solver. I use analysis of planar discontinuities. And again, this is a frequency sweep configured in the beginning by Solution Wizard. And run the analysis. I check plot, so the results will be plotted as soon as they are coming from the Symbior agents. You can see that the result is really close to unoptimized model constructed with just a piece of transmission line. Just to make sure that they behave the same, I use copy paste this link 1 model in here, and in link 1 model I restore connection to this simple microstrip model first, and second, this white section I replace with the cup model. I just drag and drop it in here and wire it. Run the analysis and plot it on the same graph again. One row, so it's a little bit different as expected because of the right discontinuities. And on TDR link 1, again diagonal elements, you can see it's very close. So TDR, this is Project 2, which is electromagnetic 3D electromagnetic analysis. This is Project 1 with approximate wider section. So now let's apply the results of the optimization to the structure, which is cutouts. To do this, I again switch to either switch to editing mode or without editing mode. I go to this geometry section with all those rectangles and add the voids. And again, I use rectangle tool, rectangle building, and plane 1. It was void length is going to be 60 mil total length, and width 30. We came with this number. Finish, and this is you can draw it in an editor too easily. Control C, Control V. It also can be optimized in this way, but this is a longer way to do this. I show very efficient way to for the optimization that does require longer running multiple analysis, and in center I set it to 25, which was the number we came up with. So right here I have to make sure that collapse is unchecked, use current variables, okay. Also in lattice box I reduce the sidewall margin multiplier to 2, just to kind of reduce the problem size. Check the problem size with F6 and make sure that the symmetry is accounted for. It accelerates analysis over the 4 times in this case with 2 plane reflection symmetry, so it's worth doing it. And the problem size is not really big, so I highlight it and run the analysis, and the problem goes into analysis. And to see the results, I also can plot it right here. Add data source, I use right mouse button menu, project tool. Dragging and dropping is not allowed when simulation is running, so I need cap to finish and I'll plot one row. Points are not coming as consecutively in case of distributed computing, so we'll wait till it's done. So simulation is done, and this is a reflection from a structure with cutouts that looks like this, with 2 cutouts in the nearest reference plane. And we can see from the graph that it makes it's very close to what we did with approximate model. This is complete link model with approximate wider section and cutouts and below the wider strip line with couple of slots. Then at high frequency it becomes divergent from this, and the reason is discontinuities first, and second the current cannot concentrate under the trace, and that's a problem. So you have to always a trade-off that wider strips, they will create much more discontinuities and high frequencies, and may also create coupling through the cutouts to the cavities below. And that was a part of this of one of the application nodes right here, I believe. That's application node. So you need to stitch the reference plane, stop reference plane with the next reference plane as close as possible to suppress all the resonances at high frequencies. And high frequencies I'm talking about above 30 gigahertz. So, and the previous model was constructed with just wider trace with the cutout. So let's just construct such link 2 model. And I copy and paste in here with click edit mode, microstrip line 50 ohm, and this middle section is going to be this cap to this cutout. Run simulation and plot the results. Graph is becoming very kind of we're crowded. We uncheck all those unoptimized models. This one is optimized, this one again unoptimized model, and this one is optimized, and this one is unoptimized. So, and this is just single structure, mounting structure, and we bring link 2 here. This is the model optimized with complete 3DM model. So we can see that the deviation is growing at high frequencies, but at low frequencies correlation is quite good. Let's see TDR. TDR basically it filters out high frequency components here. You can see that just again we can see that our electromagnetic model here has two kind of dips on both ends, effect of discontinuities, but it's really close to 50 ohm. So we designed optimal footprint for this 0402 AC coupling capacitor. Do not over optimize it because of it's going to be too sensitive to all those manufacturing variations. This is the end of this demo. To learn more, visit Symbirion or download Symbirion and try it for 15 days. Thank you.